and welcome to this early morning and cold edition of Skelly's Farm Market Up Close. Now we've had a lot of people wonder over time what happens on the farm when we get those late spring freezes that could potentially freeze off some of our crops. Now many of our crops, such as our melons, our beans, aren't even growing yet or are still protected as small plants in our greenhouses. So they're unaffected by these cold nights. But other crops, such as our strawberry plants, can be affected because they're very sensitive to the cold and even a touch of frost can hurt them. So we need to find a way to protect them. We use an above ground irrigation system on those cold nights. We pay attention closely to the temperature all night long, and once it hits about 37 degrees, we know it's time that we need to start to take action. Now frost is more common on a night that has no clouds because the clouds will keep and trap warm air closer to the Earth's surface. But when those clouds aren't there, it cools off a lot faster. So we pay attention throughout the night as this happens. As soon as we get down around 37, 36 degrees, we know it's getting close to the freezing point and we need to start the irrigation system. Now by doing this, the irrigation provides two things for the plants. First, the water itself is warmer than the air temperature, running somewhere between 50 and 60 degrees at most times. By pumping this water out into the air, it's naturally going to warm up the air as the warm water is colliding with the cold air out around the plants. It also provides a second very important part, because as the night goes on, it is possible that water will cool down towards the freezing point and actually freeze right on the plants and create frost. Now, we would think that this would be a problem, but we need to think back to science class of what happens when water changes from a liquid to a solid. When that process happens, energy is released in the form of heat. So when we have water actually freezing onto the plants as frost or even as frozen ice, there's a little bit of heat released. And because that's happening right on the plant, that heat's released right on the plant itself. Now, without getting too scientific about this, basically, this heat is what keeps the plant from dying and freezing over solid. But it's important that we continue to put at least a tenth of an inch of water on per hour throughout the night so that this energy is continually being released until the air warms up in the morning after the sun's out like it is now. In another hour or so, once our temperature gets back up in the 40s, we should be warm enough to make sure that the frost and the ice is thawed off the plants and let the warm air of the day warm everything up. Hopefully we won't have another cold night tomorrow night, but if we do, we might have to bring our water heat action back into play. And that's how we protect our strawberries when the weather gets a little cool at night. Hope to see you soon.